I was quite intrigued by how young the school was at that point, but the sort of high regard it had in the industry.
And it was recommended to me by an architect who I did work experience for.
I mean, this year is its 10th anniversary and it's considered one of the top architecture schools in the country now.
The support staff here were really fantastic, so it was somewhere that I wanted to go and study because it not only fitted my life, but I knew it was going to be a good course.
The degree actually is split up into various parts because you've got your part one where you're learning how to draw, you're learning the language of architecture.
This is how you build, this is how you do detailed drawings, this is how you use computers and softwares.
We had a variety of design modules, history modules within our first year. We learned about engineering and construction.
We have a ferro site scanner, which is for scanning site and point cloud information. We have a Brookman object scanner for little objects to get in mesh forms.
And it's all kind of just giving you the different skills to explain your schemes to different kinds of people.
Between your bachelor's and the MArch, you have to go and work for a year in the industry. It's essentially meant to sort of allow you to grow up or test your skills. I was lucky enough to go and work in New Zealand for a year in a practice out there before coming back and completing the MArch, the stage two part of the architecture degree.
The master's is a lot different from the undergraduate three-year course. It's run across 2 years, and the course is now made up of four units. The master's course as well gives you a lot more freedom than the undergraduate course. So the design side of things, which is what dominates the course, is a lot more independently kind of run by yourself.
When you finish, you normally go into another year of practice before starting doing your final qualification, which is your part three. So you're better equipped for the workplace, but still not quite fully ready to be an architect.
The Shelter Project is a great way for breaking the ice with students. So they're meant to develop a structure over the first few weeks with the intent of spending a night sleeping in it. It's a real make or break situation. If it rains and you haven't worked out the problems, then you're going to get wet. And if it's windy and you haven't closed all the gaps, you're going to get cold. So it's a sort of baptism of fire into architecture.
Each year you have the chance to go on a trip abroad.
First year Barcelona, second year Paris, third year Berlin, fourth year was my year out.
We had a trip to Vienna in second year. That was incredible.
When I came back from my MA in San Francisco, and I just came back from a Venice trip. Even when I'm working here, I'm still traveling.
And it's always fascinating to see how different countries do things. You know, every different place has its own vernacular and its own style and its own building materials.
You know, you can't learn architecture purely off a book. You can read it, you can understand it, but it's all about you know, how you experience it. You know, it's like how you, when you sketch something, you don't just sketch what you see, but you sketch what you experience off the building.
We had some large architects come and visit and give us talks, and also some new and upcoming practices. So that was really inspirational.
So immediately the students are being introduced in quite a sort of formal / informal way to potential employers.
Two people from Farrells came to our end of year show, our final crit actually, and they were on my panel, so they critiqued me. And I got in contact with one of them afterwards and I got asked to come in for an interview.
The first years interact with the fifth years and PhD students, and there's not necessarily, although we have our own spaces, there's a blurring of boundaries that allows all of the school to sort of interact.
I'm here one day a week working with a particular year group and helping them with a particular project brief that they're set, helping them develop those schemes, ideas, their concept models, and how to sort of best illustrate those or represent those ideas.
It was just a really beautiful place to study, and I think within that and the Kent School of Architecture being really up and coming, it was just kind of the perfect choice for me.
I think primarily the first thing was it was a campus university, and that really appealed to me. You know, the library's, you know, 2 minutes walk, the shop's 2 minutes walk, and it's a kind of self-contained area, so it was actually really kind of friendly, comfortable place to learn.
That was one of the theories when designing the campus, was to make it like the Oxford to Cambridge with the college system. And it just excited me actually to see that there was this new young school that had the sort of classic foundations. It reassured me that I was going to be getting a good education and a modern education.
We were told the phrase when we started on the course, we work hard but we play hard.
I know we're sort of nicknamed the course that doesn't sleep, as they all walk past our nice windows at 2 in the morning and see us all sitting over our drawing boards when all of us have done the whole school will go out. And it is the whole school will go out. It's not just your group of friends.
I obviously want to qualify as an architect eventually. And I would love to start my own practice one day.
Doing architecture doesn't just make you employable in architecture, but it makes you employable in several fields.
You get to work out what kind of architect you want to be, and that will then help you find what practice you want to go and work in. Your skills are kind of can cross all sort of boundaries, I suppose, but you've got to work out where you want to work and what architect you want to be.